Director Peter Brook once said that the creation of theater requires only two elements. One person walking across an empty space and another person watching.
I know probably the first actor was just one guy telling a story, but pretty soon he had somebody else telling him to stand up on this platform and stand here because the sun looked good, or, you know, wear this instead of that. And, you know, pretty soon it turned into theater. But, you know, the basic job of an actor is to be a storyteller. Giorgio Strehler, who ran the Teatro Piccolo di Milano, basically he says, my job is to tell stories. And I will tell them any way that I can. If I didn't have, you know, I'll tell them on a stage in front of a lot of people. If I didn't have a stage, I'd stand on a rock. If I didn't have a rock, I'd stand on the ground. If I couldn't speak, I'd do it with my hands. If I didn't have hands, I'd crawl on the ground. I mean, basically, you know, his whole thing is just that's what you're doing, is telling a story.
The people who want to do it will find a way to do it no matter what. And it could be in somebody's basement or on a street corner or in a big, you know, glamorous Broadway house. It doesn't matter. There is a love for it and a feeling that a lot of these artists have in their heart that is all pervasive, and it doesn't matter what they have to do. You think about the way people live in New York City in apartments that are the size of some people's closets, you know, and really hand to mouth. I mean, it can be a very difficult life.
The top theaters in Boston, excluding the ART and the Huntington, pay $350 a week for 38 hours of work a week. And that comes out to about $260 take home. So this is at the top of one's profession what one is paid in Boston for a full week of work. All of us have jobs that we have to work in order to subsidize the passion that we have for theater. All of us have to do other things in order, and most of us, I haven't had to do this for about 15 years, most of us work 40 hours a week and then go to rehearsal. You know, because we can't afford to live on $250 a week.
If one really is engaged and fascinated and truly has a passion for this work, and that's the best reason to pursue it.
It started in front of a campfire, you know, and no matter, it doesn't take any technology. As long as there are a couple people willing to sit down, it's just telling a story.
We're in a visual age, they constantly say, and we love the bombardment of images, but there's something so absolutely unbreakable about the link of person sitting in the audience and a person acting on the stage. Person to person, a human connection.
Theater is a way, it's one of the most primal human activities. It's a way that we eavesdrop on other people's conversations and then gossip about what we hear. Theater is nothing more or less than observing human behavior.
It's a living, breathing thing, as opposed to film and television, which is done in little pieces and put together by somebody well after the fact.
In film acting, you're bringing the whole of your life, you're bringing yourself to a certain set of conditions, that is the character. And you're trying not to lay too awful much on top of it. You're just imagining yourself in these conditions. All your same impulses, all your same distractions, attractions, detractions to this condition, this new condition, and the history of this character. So it's a lot of work up until the moment that you hit the camera. And then you're trying to be empty, because what's needed in a darkened theater is room for the audience to project themselves in there. And if you're all busy and filled up, they can't do it. And they walk out of there thinking you did the whole thing. It's sort of a card trick with mirrors. But in fact, they've related in a deep and personal way to whomever.
The movies can take us to outer space and can take us to places that we can't even imagine what they would be like. And that's what's so thrilling about the movies. They can do things that theater can never do. But what the theater can do that movies can't do is have live humans in that room and feel their breath and feel the vibrations of their voice wash over you and watch something happen for the first time and tell stories that are more verbal and literary in nature than they are visual. Though we love when those things combine in the theater, movies are not about the words, they're about the visuals. The theater's about the words.
I mean, you just can't compete with the spectacle of film. And I think this is where Broadway is really starting to suffer, because they keep, you know, after you've brought a helicopter on stage, I mean, where can you go? You know, where is it so much more satisfying to bring a helicopter on stage another way, you know, so that it's in your mind?
The element of unpredictability, which doesn't have to be so obvious, it's a living organism that's functioning in front of you in many ways, in three dimensions, psychologically, emotionally, timing-wise, recognizing the input of an audience that's out there, that's there with you in the same space. All of these make something happen that is absolutely unique for that performance. And it will never be exactly the same, even if you run for 10 years.
Nobody who comes the next night is ever going to see exactly the same thing. That you may be affected by the way a particular actor raises her hand and tilts her head, and you know that that moment has passed and she will never be able to achieve it again, no matter, you know, how consummate a mover she is.
There is no other art that invites an audience to watch the art take place before it. An artist can come back, a painter, and develop, and before he shows you, she shows you the work, she's worked on it for a long time, and then this is the finished product. It's different with acting in the theater, it should be anyway. I really am going to try to create and discover this truth at this moment, the real truth, as I know it, as the truth can only exist, which is my interpretation of it. But when you touch on that truth, which doesn't happen too often, as I say, the attempt is valiant and noble, but sometimes you do discover it. And when it happens, it has nothing to do with you as an actor. Very interesting thing. And not only do you know it's happening, everybody in that place knows it. Even if they have come to the theater for the first and only time in their lives, or if it's the 5,000th time they've been to the theater, in the hope of seeing and experiencing being part of this thing that's taking place.